we discussed the reaction of the EU towards the financial crisis and what has been done in what we call the new regulatory setup. And I believe over the last 5-6 years, the EU has done an enormous effort in reacting to the holes of the lack of financial supervision in certain areas. I think about the lack of supervision of rating agents. I think about the lack of supervision of derivatives markets. I think about the lack of supervision of hedge funds, increasing the quality of capital in the banking sector. On all these items, the EU, but not only the European Union, but also international authorities have reacted in the context of the G20 to improve the overall regulatory framework for the financial sector. In addition, we have seen in Europe that we have created a banking union. What does this mean? This means that the European Central Bank will be supervising the largest banks in the Eurozone, and by this become the unique or the single supervisor for these large banks, and avoid the inefficiencies or the eventual holes in supervision which we had seen or which were revealed during the financial crisis. I think this is a very good development. The European Central Bank has a good reputation, very good reputation as a central bank, which it can now use to improve the supervision of these commercial banks in Europe, certainly the large ones. The ECB will supervise about, in asset terms, 80% of the European financial system. The only thing I would warn against is that the European Central Bank may become too powerful, what they call a central bank which at the same time is in charge of monetary stability, meaning ensuring that the prices are more or less stable, and at the same time financial stability, which can lead to some conflicts of interest eventually, that some financial stability considerations, meaning to keep the banking sector afloat, may play a role in decisions on price stability or vice versa. So the ECB could also become too powerful, and some of its decisions may eventually be too authoritarian at a certain stage. So I believe over the long term, it was very useful that we could give the European Central Bank this task of banking supervision now, because there is a clause in the treaty, the EU treaty, which allowed to do this without a treaty change. That probably in the longer term, for which we'll have to have a treaty change, financial supervision should become a separate institution, separate from the European Central Bank, that the ECB can continue to focus only on its price stability function, and that you have a financial supervisor which looks at the soundness of the banking system, which looks after prudential supervision, and which looks after financial stability.